Okay, make sure you have a large bowl for this because you're going to be using 6 cups of flour in this. So, so far in the bowl, I have put 2 cups of warm water. Okay, and then you're going to add your yeast. It calls for 1.5 tablespoons of yeast. So there's one. And kind of eyeball it. So that's the yeast and the water. And you're also going to add the sugar. Calls for 2/3 cup of white sugar. Actually, yeah, I have a third cup measuring cup in my flour, so we'll take that out of there and just do 2 of these. So 2/3 cup of sugar. So there's 1/3 cup. Get that a little bit more level. There's 2/3 cup. Okay. So, and then I'm going to take a spoon and gently stir this, trying to keep the yeast down in the water. I'm going to try to dissolve that sugar a little bit. That should be good. Then we're going to let this set until it proofs. And proofing is when you'll see what it looks like now. It'll get all bubbly on top. And that usually takes, 10 to 15 minutes in warm weather or in a warm kitchen. So we'll be back to see what that looks like. Okay, it's warm out today, and in about 10 or 12 minutes, this is what that same bowl of yeast looks like. And you can see it's all like foamed up and bubbly. Hopefully you can see this. So that's what you want. If it doesn't do that after, probably 15, 20 minutes, I'd say your yeast isn't any good. And the other thing I wanted to say is I buy yeast in bulk because I make bread all the time and other things like cinnamon rolls and things. If you don't buy it in bulk, for this recipe, I'd buy at least 2 of the little packets of dry yeast and then measure it out to, 1.5 tablespoons. It's going to take at least probably 1.5 packs to equal that. So this is where we're at right now. And next we're going to add the oil, which is 1/4 cup of vegetable oil. I don't happen to have vegetable oil, so I'm going to use canola oil. Hopefully that won't make that much difference in the flavor. I hope not. 1/4 cup. Okay. So, 1/4 cup of oil is going in. This is a good recipe in case you don't have like butter or milk or something on hand. You can make it pretty much, with just the water, the ingredients I told you, the flour, sugar, water, and yeast. So that's probably why the Amish made it. They probably didn't always have butter and milk handy. Unless, of course, they had a dairy cow, which most of them had. That didn't make sense, did it? Anyhow, okay, next we're going to add... It says to add the salt, but I don't do that till later because salt can kill yeast. I usually add it after I've added some flour. So it says mix in flour 1 cup at a time. And we're going to do 6 cups of flour. If you have bread flour, that would be ideal. I just use regular organic flour. So, measure out 6 cups. And I'm not one that is exact. If it's a little bit over, whatever. Especially with bread, because you're going to net it or knead it. I always say net instead of knead. You're going to knead it. That's 1 cup of flour. And always, I try to use either wood or a plastic spoon, because I think metal reacts with yeast. Maybe I might be wrong, but I've always done it with a wooden spoon. Mix as good as you can. And then when it gets looking like that, we'll add the next. So far we got 1 cup of flour. Okay, now 2 cups. And it'll start mixing together better as you add more flour to it. Try to scrape the sides and the bottom too, because sometimes the yeast will stick to the sides. You don't want that. I may put a light on when lighting here doesn't look very good. Okay. I'm going to go put a light on and see if that makes a difference. Hold on. I think I was just filming when I wasn't doing anything. Here's the 3rd cup. I can see it's starting to look more like a dough now. Okay, that was 3 cups of flour. And at this point, I'm going to go ahead and add my salt, because I don't think it will bother the yeast at this point. It's 1/2 teaspoons, not tablespoons. 1/2 teaspoons of salt. There was one, there goes the half. Okay, let's stir that in. Go to number 4. Okay, number 4. Now we're getting even more like a dough. Finally. And what I do is usually go up to the next to the last cup, which would be 5 cups, and then finish it on the floured surface when you're adding the last cup. I'll show you that. Okay. I think we're just going to have enough flour here. Here's 5 cups. Okay, you see how it's getting almost too thick to stir. Okay, now at this point, I'm going to flour my surface of my table. Keep some flour handy, and I'll be right back to show you this. Whoop. I just dump flour all over. You guys like this because it's a comedy, huh? Okay. I have to do this till it's smooth and elastic, where it wants to sponge back at you there. It's getting that way now. See how nice and smooth that is? Then you want to add a little bit more flour. I'm trying to use most of it up. Okay, I think that's going to be about it. Then you want to kind of roll it into a ball. Put it back into your bowl. I'll try to do this one-handed. Put it back in the bowl. And again, they tell you to oil the bowls. I don't always do that unless my dough is really, really sticky. This isn't, so. Put it back in the bowl, and you're going to wait till that's doubled in bulk, which would be pretty far up on this bowl. And you're going to cover it with a towel. I usually use like a flour sack towel. Get this out of the way here. There, like a flour sack towel, which doesn't have a lot of lint to stick into your dough. In case the dough rises and hits it, it's not going to do anything. Put any lint into it. And every once in a while, check it to make sure it's not hitting that. Because if it is, then it's time to shape it. So we're going to let that dough sit for about an hour. If it's a hot room, it might only take 45 minutes. Or if it's real cold out, hour and a half maybe. But average about an hour. Okay, that's how much it has risen since a half hour. So I'm going to cover back up. I'm just checking on it. Okay, it's been an hour. And that's what it looks like all the way up to the top. So now I'm going to punch it down. I flour my hand and then punch it down a bunch. And I'm going to try to take a knife and kind of divide it in half. If you want to get really technical, you can get a scale out and weigh each half to, if you want them exact. But I'm just going to try to get this separated with a little bit with a knife and then take my hands and pull them apart. I'll be right back. Okay, I have two loaf pans and I've greased those. And then I've got the one part separated from this other part in the bowl. And normally you do this with two hands, so I'm going to kind of try to show you with one. Get your hand floured and kind of flatten it out a little bit. Again, I guess some people are perfectionists, but I'm not. I'm just going to kind of do this like so. It's about that big. I'm going to turn the light on again. I don't know if that helped or not. So it's about that big. And then flip over one side. Flip the other side over that so it looks like a little burrito. And then bring the one side over that. And the other side over that. And then kind of, again, I usually do this with two hands, which is easier, but kind of pinch the ends together. Kind of roll it a little bit. So there you go. Kind of, you know, like pinch the ends and get them under. If you got little ends sticking out there. And then put it seam side down into the pans. I'll show you that in a minute. Okay. And with two hands, when you roll that out, you know, and when you pinch that together, kind of roll it on the table to try to get it a little bit tighter bread roll, you know, than what I showed you. A little bit tighter than that. I couldn't do it very well with one hand, but anyhow, they're going to raise, so it's not going to really matter that much. If it was one that was on a cookie sheet, it would be different. But here we are with our two loaves. And now we're going to cover this again. And you're going to cover that and wait at least 30 minutes or until the bread has risen about an inch above the pans. And then we will bake it. I'm just checking our bread. It's getting there. During the last, I don't know, 10, 15 minutes or so, start preheating your oven also. You want your oven preheated very well for bread, You don't want to just put it in there and then turn the temperature up, you know. So get that going. The recipe calls for 350 degrees. So I'm going to preheat it to 350. Okay, those are looking good. That to me looks like it's at least an inch. I'll get this to be exact. Let's look. Yep, it's probably an inch. Oops, I hope I don't deflate it now. It's an inch right there. Yeah, if you puncture these or shake them too much, they will deflate and you have to start all over raising them. So I'm going to put these in the oven and they're going to go in for a half hour. Okay, I put the bread in for a half hour. And when you put them in the oven, you want to make sure not to slam the door on the oven because that can also deflate your bread. So be very gentle putting it in there. And, you know, later after it gets the crust is browner, you don't have to be so careful. But right now, you can deflate them. Oh, they look beautiful. Pull these out. Just beautiful. Look at those. And there's your Amish white bread. I'm going to let that cool for a few minutes in the pan and then I'll pull them out and let them finish cooling on this rack. And when you do that, I usually lay them sideways so they don't squish all down. They stay, you know, inflated well. Because sometimes if they, you know, if they're warm, they'll kind of squish down while they're cooling. I keep wanting to say drying. Getting mixed up with my dehydrating videos. So there's my Amish bread. Enjoy. Okay, after 10 minutes, they slid right out of the pans. And as you can see, I put them on their side so that the volume will stay and they won't squish down while they're cooling. They're still very, very hot. That's my bread. Now you can freeze these. They freeze really well. Just make sure the bags are sealed good. So that's probably what I'll do. I'll freeze one and we'll eat the other one tonight. Yummy. Beautiful. This is kind of a sweet white bread. Sweet Amish white bread.